This is a tutorial on how to sync data from a table in a Google Doc to a Coda table when you have multiple Google Docs in a Google Drive folder. A very niche use case, but I thought it'd be very interesting to show how this script works using Google Apps Script. So before I get into using the script, I just want to kind of show you what this would look like. So if you have a Google Drive folder here with a bunch of Docs, so I only have three here. You notice I have two Google Docs that I own, but I have one Google Doc that's a shortcut to another Google Doc that's owned by someone else, and you can tell that that's a shortcut with that little arrow symbol. This is the actual Google Doc for Fresh Prince of Bel-Air Doc, and you'll notice that there's words, but there's also a table that contains information. Generally speaking, about this Google Doc, sometimes it's a project brief or it might be a bug report, and you'll have a kind of standard table like this with the column names along the left-hand side in column one and then the values in column two. So this is great to see in the Google Doc, but it's not really useful when you have many different Google Docs that you want to kind of aggregate and see in one place. So what we're going to do is take the data just from the table only from all these Google Docs and put them into one table in a Coda Doc so that you can sort and filter and organize the data and also quickly find the Google Doc that you're interested in based on all this metadata from this table. So I created a table in this Coda Doc, and you'll notice that I have the exact same column names along the top, like name, genre, number of episodes, as the properties in the first column. So name, genre, number of episodes, who picked, so on and so forth. So these are all matching the exact same column names from the Google Doc, with the exception of one extra column that I've added to my Coda Doc, which is a Google Doc link. Now that's going to store the actual link to the Google Doc that we have open right here. So let's start with using the script to get the data from these tables that are kind of trapped or stuck in these Google Docs into one main table where we can sort and filter and organize. So if I go back to the script, I'm going to just, the first thing you want to put in is your API key. I'm going to pause the video for a second so I can put in my API keys, and I won't show this to the public, so I'll pause the video for 1 second. Okay, so in line 9, it contains my actual API key, but I've hidden it from view so that it's not made public, but you want to put your own API key into the Google Apps Script rather. And you can do that by going to your account settings. If you scroll down below, there should be an API section here where you can generate an API token. The next is to get the target doc ID for your Coda Doc. So let's move this over here. That's everything after the underscore D in the URL of the doc. So I'm copying this and pasting it here. Your target table ID. This is, if you turn on developer mode, again, this is through your account settings. Developer, actually I think it's the very bottom here, advanced settings. Labs, enable developer mode. If you turn this on, then you can click on these three dots next to a table in Coda. This is an empty table. I can click on this, click on copy table ID, and this will be the target table ID I put in here. So we sync data from the Google Docs into this table ID. The final thing is the Google Doc, this is a default column name, Google Doc link. Again, we added this to this column here. You can name this something else, but make sure you add in that name here. Like if you call this Google Doc links or something like that, this would have to be the exact same column name as you have here. I'm just going to leave this as Google Doc link for now. The final variable you have to set is your Google Drive folder ID. So I'm going to go back to my Google Drive. The Google Drive folder ID is everything after slash folders in your Google Drive. I'm just going to copy that and paste this here. And then I'm all set. Now, what the script does, it goes through all these Google Doc files it takes data from these tables and it's going to put it into this one main table in Coda. So I'm going to click on runSync here and hit play. And it's going to run, it's going to think. And once this yellow message goes away, the data should sync over. And there we have it. So we have the name of the, I'm just going to put this across next to the Google Doc. You notice the name matches exactly what's in the second column of the Google Doc, the genre, number of episodes, and everything kind of syncs over correctly. And what's really neat is if you shared the doc with certain people, they will show up in the doc if you've just matched, if you have the name in the Google Doc. So for instance, in my who picked column here or row, I have Adam Davis. I've shared my Google Doc with Adam Davis already, and this person now will show up in the dropdown in my Coda Doc. And this makes it easy if you want to email them or send them a Slack message. They show up kind of as like this really rich reference inside the Coda table, which you can now play with. So now once you have all the data in your Coda table, you can sort by number of episodes or by the original release date. And it makes it much easier to find the Google Doc you need versus having to search through Google Drive. Now what happens if you add a new doc to this folder? So I have this, so we have Billions, Doug, Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, some of my favorite TV shows when I was growing up. We have Saved by the Bell doc, which is not in my Google Drive folder yet. I'm just going to go over here into a separate window and move that Saved by the Bell doc over to this TV shows folder in my Google Drive. Just give me 1 second. So if I hit that, so this should now, if I refresh this, we should see that Saved by the Bell. There it is. And it's very similar format. It has the same kind of name, genre, all the same columns or headers, if you want to call them that. And so now when I click on the, when I run the script one more time, it's going to find any new Google Docs that I've added to my Drive folder. In this case, it's the Saved by the Bell doc. And it's going to add the data from that Saved by the Bell doc to my Coda doc at some point. Let's give it some time to think. Oh, it should be done by now. Let's just try refreshing the doc, and that Saved by the Bell doc row should show up. And there's that Saved by the Bell doc. I think the reason why it's not at the very bottom is because this is sorted, but any new Google Docs you add to that Drive folder will now show up to the bottom of the table. And the important thing is that the table in your Google Docs have to be have the same consistent format with the same column names or header or row names in this case, and they have to be structured in this way where the column name is in the column one, and then the values for those properties are in column two. The final caveat is that you can't insert hyperlinks. If I made this Billions doc, if I made this a hyperlink to www.billions.com, these links don't carry over into Coda. It's just text. And that's how you can sync data from tables in a Google Doc into a main table in Coda.